ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सो टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक. इट इज एरिया ऑफ ट्रायंगल. सो इन द प्रीवियस स्टैंडर्ड व्हाट वी कैन लर्न इफ वी हैव इन द राइट एंगल ट्रायंगल लाइक दिस एंड वी कैन गिव इट्स नेम ए बी एंड सी. सो इट इज एक्चुअली द राइट एंगल ट्रायंगल. सो इफ वी हैव इन द राइट एंगल ट्रायंगल एंड इफ वी वॉन्ट टू फाइंड आउट द एरिया ऑफ ट्रायंगल, सो वी हैव अ डायरेक्टली फॉर्मूला. एरिया ऑफ ट्रायंगल इज इक्वल टू 1 by 2 base into height. So it is base and it is sometime height or it is also called altitude. So we can also write like that 1 by 2 BC into AB, because BC is our base and this is our altitude. Clear? Same we have in the one triangle like that. So it is also right angle. See that it is also right angle. So if base and altitude is given, so we can put in this. Suppose base is 6 and height is 8, so here we will put 8 into 6, so 6 4s are 24. So it means what? It means if base and height or altitude is given, so we can apply this formula for finding the area of a triangle. But if the coordinate is given, suppose 2, 3, -1, -2, 3, 7. So if this kind of the coordinate is given, if we plot that coordinate in our graph, so and if we join this all points, so we have in the shape of triangle. And now if I want to find the area of a triangle, so how can I find the area of triangle if it is not a right angle triangle? So if coordinate is given, clear, if coordinate is given, so we have one directly formula for that. Clear? Coordinate, or it is also called vertice. So if vertice is given, so formula is like that, 1 by 2 x1. So here first coordinate we can declare it is x1 y1, so it is x2 y2, and this is x3 y3. So here we will put x1 is equal to 3, then y2 minus y3, so 3 minus minus plus. So if we put the all the value in this formula, so we can directly find the answer of that area of a triangle. Clear? So how can we apply in our real situation? So for that we are going to start our exercise number 7.3, question number 1. So in this question we are applying this formula. Clear? So here see that 3 coordinates are given. It is x1, we can declare it is x1 y1, it is x2 y2, and this is x3 y3. Clear? So now we will put our formula. Area of a triangle is equal to 1 by 2 in bracket, what is our formula? x1 y2 minus y3 plus x2 y3 minus y1 plus x3 y1 minus y2. So it is our formula. Now we will put all the value. 1 by 2, what is x1? It is 2. y2 minus y3 y2 minus, what is y3? It is -4. Plus what is x2? It is -1. y3 minus y1 y3 minus y1 plus x3, it is 2, y1 it is 3, minus y2 it is 0. Clear? It is 0. Now simplify this all. 2 minus minus plus, so 0 plus 4 it will be 4, plus minus minus it is -7, plus 3 minus 0, so it is only 3. Now simplify this all. 4 2 are 8, minus minus plus, 7 1 are 7, and 2 3 are 6. So 8 plus 7 15, 15 plus 6 21. Now 21 divide with 2, so 21, so 2 1 are 2, so here 1, so it is 10. So here we put point, so 2 5 are. So what is our answer? 10.5 you need. Now similarly for a second, it is the same example as our question number 1. So do it here in your homework. Clear? Both have the same example. We can first of all we can put the formula. It is x1 y1, this is x2 y2, and this is x3 y3. Now we will put this and simplify this and find it answer. Now last, next question, question number 2. So in question 2, they are asking, and each of the following find the value of k for the points are collinear. So here in this question, in each of the following find the value of k. So in this all question we need to find the value of k for which the points are collinear. So first of all, if we draw this all point on our graph, so we can see that what, if these are the collinear point like that 1, 2, and 3 point, if it is collinear, so they can't form a triangle. Clear? So they are already saying that the points are collinear. So if points are collinear, it means what? Area of triangle will be 0. Clear? So we can write here one condition: the points are a collinear, so that's why the area of triangle must be 0. So first of all we can write area of triangle, and here it is x1 y1, this is x2 y2, and this is x3 y3. Now we will put our formula: x1 bracket y2 minus y3 plus x2 in bracket y3 minus y1 plus x3 y1 minus y2. Now simplify this. So if it is collinear point, it means what? Area of triangle will be 0. Now what is x1? 7. y2? 1. y3? It is k. Plus x2? 5. y3? k. Minus in bracket minus 2. Plus x3? It is 3. Next, y1 minus 2 minus y2? It is minus 1. Now these two is going second set, so it will be 0. 7 ones are 7. 7 into k, so it is 7k. We can expand the bracket. Minus minus become plus. Here minus minus plus, so it is minus 3. Now simplify this all. 7 minus 7k plus 5k plus 10 plus minus, it will be minus 9. Now is equal to 0. 5 plus minus minus, so it is minus 2k. Now 10 plus 7, 17. 17 minus 9, so 17 minus 9. 17 minus 9, so it will be 8. This 2k is going second set, so it become plus. So what is the value of k? 8 divided by 2, so answer it is 4. Now question second, it is same as our question number first. Clear? So first of all you can find the, you can put the formula, then you can simplify this, so you can get the answer of k. So it will be in your homework. So question number 3, find the area of triangle by joining the midpoints of a triangle whose vertices are given. So first of all we can draw the one triangle A, B and C. So first point it is 0 comma minus 1, second it is 2 comma 1, and third it is 0 comma 3. So find the area of triangle formed by the midpoint. So here this word is given. So it means what? First of all we can find the midpoint of this, this and this. So how can we find the midpoint? So midpoint of AB, we can declare it is P. is equal to P. So how can we find the midpoint? Here we have one formula. This formula x1 plus x2 divided with 2, y1 plus y2 divided with 2. So P, what is x1? 0, x2 is 2. So 0 plus 2 divided with 2, y1 minus 1, y2 1 divided with 2. So what is its coordinate? 2 plus 0, 2 divided with 2, so it is 1. Plus 1 minus 1, 0, 0 divided with 2, so it is 0. Now similarly, we can also find the midpoint of BC. Midpoint of BC, it is P, and what is its coordinate? 1 comma 0. Then midpoint of, we can declare it is Q. So once again we can write Q in bracket x1 plus x2, so 2 plus 0 divided with 2, y1 plus y2, so 1 plus 3 divided with 2, so 2 divided with 2, 1, 4 divided with 2, so it is 2. So this point is 1 comma 2. Next, midpoint of AC, we can declare it is R. So once again we can apply the formula, so 0 plus 0 and minus 1 plus 3, y1 plus y2 divided with 2, so 0, 3 minus 2, so it is 1. So now we have all the, so now we can join this all point. So we have one triangle, see that PQR, clear, it is PQ and R. So first of all we can find the area of ABC, and then we can find the area of PQR, and then we can take the ratio. Clear? So area of triangle is equal to x 1 by 2 in bracket x1 y2 minus y3, x2 y1 minus y2, x3, sorry, y3 minus y1. Here x3 y 1 minus y2. Clear? So this is our formula: x1 y2 minus y3, x2 y3 minus y1. We can also check this formula. So okay, now next, 1 by 2, what is x1? So first of all this is x1 y1, this is x2 y2, and this is x3 y3. So what is x1? It is 0. So y2, 1 minus y3, 3, plus x2, it is 2, y3, 3, y1 minus 1, plus x3, x3 is 0 once again, y1 minus y2. So what is y1? Minus 1, y2 it is 1. Now simplify this. So 0 into any of term, it will be 0. Minus minus plus, so 3 plus 1, 4, 4 2 za 8, and minus 0 into any of the term, it will be 0. So what is our answer? 1 by 2 into 8, so answer is 4 unit. Clear? So this is the area of triangle ABC. Now similarly we can also find the area of triangle, which triangle? PQR. So once again same formula: x1 y2 minus y3, x2 y3 minus y1, x3 y1 minus y2. Here, so this is x1 y1, so this, what is the coordinate of Q? It is 1 comma 2. So this is x2 y2, and this is x3 y3. So 1 by 2, what is x1? It is 1, y2, y2 it is 2, y3 it is 1, plus x2, x2 it is 1, y3, y3 once again 1, minus y1 it is 0, plus x3, 0, in bracket y1, 0, minus y2 it is 2. Simplify this all. So 1 by 2, 2 minus 1, 1, 1 into 1, so it is 1 plus 1 minus 0, so 1, 1 into 1, so 1, 0 into any of the term, it will be 0. So 1 plus 1, it is 2, 2 divided with 2, so answer it is 1 unit, clear, answer it is 1 unit. Now they are also asking, find the ratio of this triangle to the area of given triangle. So we can write like that, area of triangle ABC upon area of triangle PQR. So what is the area? First of all, okay, so here first of all we can write area of triangle PQR, because they are saying that ratio of these triangles. So first of all, midpoint triangle, and then area of triangle A, B and C. So it is 1 by 4, clear. So what is its ratio? 1 by 4. Now next question number 4, find the area of quadrilateral. So it means what? Quadrilateral is like that. So first point is given, we can declare its name V, B, C and D. So what is A? Minus 4 comma minus 2. What is B? Minus 3 comma minus 5. C 3 minus comma 2, and it is 2 comma 3. So here the quadrilateral is given. So how can we find the area of quadrilateral? So here we can draw the one line. So we have a two triangle A, B and C, and second A, D and C. So it is our second triangle. This is our first triangle. Clear? So first of all we can find the area of ABC, then we can find the area of ADC, and then we can add these both triangle area. So we can find the area of quadrilateral. So first of all we can start with area of triangle ABC. So this is X1, Y1, X2, Y2. X3 Y3, clear. We can see this only triangle A, B and C. So now we will put our formula X1 Y2 minus Y3, X2 Y3 minus Y1, X3 Y1 minus Y2, clear. Next, now 1 by 2, what is x1? It is minus 4, y2 it is minus 5, y3 it is once again minus 2. So plus x2 it is minus 3. Now y3 minus 2 in minus y1, so once again minus 2. Plus x3 it is 3, then y1 it is minus 2, minus y2, so once again minus 5. Now simplify this all. 1 by 2, minus 4, minus minus, plus, so minus 5 plus 3, plus minus minus, minus minus plus, so minus 2 plus 2, here 3, minus 2 plus. Now simplify this all. 1 by 2, minus 4, so here minus plus minus become minus, so here actually it is 2, so here we can write 2, clear. So plus minus, so it is minus 3, then it is 0, here plus 3, so 1 by 2, 12, minus minus become plus, into 0, 3 threes are 9, so 12 plus 9 it is 21 by 2. Now similarly we can also find the area of triangle ADC with this one, AD and C, second triangle. So this is once again x1 y1, now this become x2 y2, and this will be remain, so these both point will be remain same. This is our x2 y2. Once again we can put the same formula, clear? X1 y2 minus y3, x2 y3 minus y1, x3 y1 minus y2. Now simplify this all. X1, what is x1? Minus 4, y2, 3, y3 plus x2, it is 2, y3 minus 2, y1 minus 2 plus x3, x3 it is 3, y1 minus 2, y2 it is 3. Now simplify this all. 1 by 2 minus 4, minus minus plus, so 3 plus 2 5, minus minus plus 2 minus 2, so it is 0 and it is minus 5. So 1 by 2, 5 4 is a minus 20, 0 and minus 15, so 35 divide with 2, minus 35 divide with 2, but area of triangle value it will be always plus, clear? So here, so it is minus plus 35 by 2. Now we can add these both area, area of ABC plus area of ADC. So we can write like that, total area of quadrilateral ABCD is equal to area of triangle ABC plus area of triangle ADC. So it is 7. First, what is area of triangle ABC? It is 21 by 2 plus 35 by 2. Here you can, you must remember that thing, area we have an always the positive value. So 2 is our LCM. So 35 plus 1, 5, 6, 3 plus 2, 5 is divided with 2. So answer it is 28 unit. Now last, question number 5. You have studied in class 9 that a median of a triangle, divide it into the two equal triangle into the two equal areas. So verify the result. So suppose we have one triangle A, B and C. So coordinate is given 4 comma minus 6, it is 3 comma minus 2 and last 5 comma 2. Now they are saying that what? Median divide the triangle into the two equal areas. So we can draw the median. Clear? So this is our median and we can give its name, it is D. Here we can give its name D. So how can you find the coordinate of D? D is a midpoint on BC. Clear? So first of all, midpoint of BC, we can declare it is D. Now bracket, x1 plus x2 divide with 2, y1 plus y2 divide with 2. So D, what is x1? It is 3, 5, minus 2 plus 2. So 8, 8 divided by 2, so 4 comma 0. What is the coordinate of D? It is 4 comma 0. Now first of all we can find the area of ADB, so this triangle. Clear? So area of triangle ADB. Clear? So we can declare it is x1, y1, this is x2, y2 and this is x3, y3. So once again we can put the formula, x1, y2 minus y3, x2, y3 minus y1, x3, y1 minus y2. Now simplify this, what is x1? 4, y2, so it is 0. Y3 minus minus plus, what is x2? It is 4, y3 minus 2, y1 plus 6, because minus minus plus, x3, x3 it is 3, y1 minus 6 and y2 it is 0. Now simplify this all. 0 plus 2, 2 into 4, it is 8. 6 minus 2, 4, 4 4s are 16. Plus 6 3s are minus 18. So 18 plus 8, 24, 24 minus 18, 6. So 1 by 2 in bracket 6. So answer it is 3, 2 3s are 6. So what is the area of triangle ADB? It is 3 unit. Now we can also find the area of triangle ADC. This is x1 y1, x2 y2, and this is x3 y3. Now once again we can simplify that. x1 y2 minus y3, x2 y3 minus y1, x3 y1 minus y2. 1 by 2, what is x1? It is 4. y2, it is 0. y3, 2. x2, 4. Then y3, 2. y1, minus minus plus. x3, 5. y1, minus 6. And y2, it is 0. Now simplify these all. 0 minus 2, minus 8. Plus 6 plus 2, 8. 8 4s are 32. And 5 6 are minus 30. So here 30, so 2 minus 8, so minus 6. So 1 by 2 in bracket minus 6. So 2 3s are, so minus 3. But area of triangle, it always having the positive value. So it is 3 unit. Clear? So it means what? This median, the median of AD divide the two equal triangle. So we can say that, yes, median of a triangle divide triangle into two equal area. Clear? It is divide median of a triangle, divide the triangle into the two equal area of a triangle. So this is proof. So last three sum, what we can see that first sum we have an triangle, and first of all we can find the midpoint of a triangle, and in second we have an the quadrilateral. So we can divide the quadrilateral into the two equal triangle, and last median also divide the triangle into the two equal triangles. So this is our chapter number 7, and now the chapter number 7 will be, it's chapter number 7 over.